Nancy Pelosi retaking the gavel as Speaker of the House and taking on the president, claiming he doesn't know how to work with women in power.
Do you think he deals with you differently because you're a woman?
I have no idea. We'll see. Maybe now how he will deal with the Speaker of the House. But I hope he recognizes that a new day is dawn in America. I don't know if he knows how to deal with women in power and women with strength, but we'll see.
So what is the new House Speaker getting wrong? Lara Trump spearheaded the Trump-Pence Women's Empowerment Tour, is the wife of Eric Trump and campaign advisor to the president, and she joins us now. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
Great to have you here. I found that to be such an odd comment by Nancy Pelosi, given how many women Donald Trump, President Trump, has elevated. I kept thinking of Kellyanne Conway, Sarah Sanders.
Absolutely.
I mean, the list goes on and on. Ivanka, his daughter,
the women
Gina
in his
Haspel, Betsy DeVos,
exactly.
Kirsten Nielsen. I mean, the list is a mile long that I have in my hand,
yes.
And I'm sure some are missing here. What do you make of this comment?
Well, first of all, I think it's ridiculous, but it is true identity politics. The Democrats really are scared of President Trump because he's doing such a great job. And I think Nancy Pelosi knows that Donald Trump works very well with women. He was a businessman in his past. He has never cared about your gender or about your color. Donald Trump expects results and he sees successes and failures. So that is such a ridiculous comment from Nancy Pelosi. And I think she knows that. He's going to work great with the women in Congress. I have no doubt about it. And she will see. She said, we'll wait and see. She will see. He's going to be great.
Yeah. And even while he was a businessman, I mean, so true because so many women were promoted. It's
Absolutely.
Just a bizarre comment. Rashida Tlaib has made some interesting comments about the impeachment of President Trump, coming out, not the most civil comments. I want you to take a listen and then get your response.
When your son looks at you and says, Mama, look, you won, bullies don't win. And
no.
I said, baby, they don't, because we're going to go in there, we're going to impeach them.
Now, she's obviously a House Democrat. I thought that Democrats were supposed to be stewards of civility. Did I get that wrong?
Well, talk about a bully. She's talking about bullies. That's a bully right there for you. And she obviously doesn't understand how the impeachment process actually works, clearly. There is nothing that they're going to be able to impeach this president on. They have this notion and this dream that there is something out there. There is nothing. But I think that's what Democrats default to. They know they can't beat the president mm-hmm. because he is doing, again, such a great job. The people of this country are behind him. I always say more people are going to vote for this president in 2020 than even did in 2016. And I think they know that. And I think they're looking for anything they can to take this president down. I think it's ridiculous. Of course, they tout themselves as being so tolerant and not judgmental of anyone and really being like a party of love. Obviously, that is not the case. It's really sad that this exists out there. But when you look at comments like this, they all come from the Democrat side. Mm-hmm. You look at things that have been said before by so many Democrats, kick them in the head when they're down. You know, Eric mm-hmm. Holder saying that. The number of times that we've heard that people should get up and in their faces and harass Trump supporters and Republicans. It all comes from the Democrat side. And I think people are noticing that.
You talked before a little bit about people being behind President Trump, and one of those issues actually involves border security. And I just want to get your take on what's been going on with the shutdown, because there have been a lot of calls for compromise for the left and right to come together, Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer, to meet Donald Trump in the middle some way. And I'm just not seeing a path to compromise when you have one side of the aisle on the left, who frankly seems to be making jokes about it. I mean, Nancy Pelosi saying, oh, you know, we'll give you a dollar for border security, and not taking these issues of drug trafficking, human trafficking seriously. Do you think President Trump will cave on this?
Well, first of all, it's not funny. People's lives are at stake, and the future of our country is at stake. And that is why the president is taking this so very seriously. Something has to happen with this. And it wouldn't be so far-fetched that the Democrats oppose this if not too many years ago, they hadn't fully agreed with what the president wants to do, wants to protect our borders. They, in the Obama days, were all in on border security. And now, all of a sudden, because we have this president, they have changed their minds. And I think that's, I mean, it's a little bit ridiculous. I sure hope there is a path to getting a wall. I think this country needs a wall, and I know the president will fight to the bitter end to get it.
What if they come to the president, Democrats, and they say, all right, listen, we're not going to give you $5.6 billion, but we'll give you $3 billion. Do you think he's flexible, President Trump, on the number? Does he just want some acknowledgement of the wall? Where do you think he's willing to budge on his end?
Well, given Nancy Pelosi wants $20 billion for foreign aid, and she can't give $5 billion and for our own country. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be very hard for the president to swallow anything less than $5 billion.
Thank you so much for being here. Really looking forward to see how everything plays out, including the shutdown, and glad to see those economic numbers. Really appreciate your take on all this.
Thanks so much.
Thanks so much.